It's that time of year. I'm heading back to Shackleford Banks for another orienteering event on the dunes. On the way there, I've passed many of the same warehouses near the city, construction sites along the highway, and then farmland and woods before crossing an intracoastal waterway just before getting to Beaufort. Here, I have finally had my first glimpse of the ocean, albeit only reaching from the mainland to Rachel Carson Reserve between Beaufort and Shackleford Banks. We've just embarked on the 30-minute ferry ride to get to the island. Everyone is geared up for the windy boat ride. The wind is making it feel about 10 degrees colder than it actually is. Heading away from the no-wake zone only makes it colder, and I ended up turning off my camera here so it didn't get too wet or fall in from all the wind. And we finally arrived back at Shackleford Banks 363 days after my first trip. Just like before, the rolling dunes can be seen even from the shoreline, and the number of horse poop piles seems to have only grown. In fact, it seems like some of the poop from my last visit is still here, only drier than the fresh stuff. The scrub brush covering areas of the island is still flourishing, though the cacti seem fewer in number. But that's not to say several didn't get stuck to my pants. The number of bottles, plastic, and glass seems to have grown, and along the shoreline I found a variety of styrofoam and plastic bits. Along with that, I found a balloon. Most likely the party didn't happen on the island, which means someone on the mainland let a balloon go free. I mean, come on, people. The wild horses are still healthy and well, as evidenced by the additional piles of poop, among other signs. I've come to the island again to do another orienteering course. This course started and finished opposite of what I'd done in the year prior. Not only is the course different, but the shoreline along the Atlantic Ocean side of the island seems to have eroded away and been reshaped by weather, the tides, and rising sea levels. In my first Shackleford Banks video, I brought up three orienteering skills. But what exactly is pace counting, and how do you use attack points and handrails? Counting your steps, or pace counting, is an essential skill as an orienteer because distance is a key component to finding a control. For me, I count my steps in fours.
1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2.
About 34 steps, as I like to call them, is 100 meters for me. In orienteering, we measure things in metric units because it is much easier to do the math quickly in your head, and because orienteering is a mainly European sport.
28, 1, 2, 3, 29, 1, 2, 3, 30.
Another skill I mentioned in my first Shackleford Banks video was using attack points. These are easily recognizable features that you can hit 100 to 150 meters before a control to confirm you are where you think you are. The best attack points at Shackleford Banks are the fences. On this map, there are three fences that can be used as attack points. One here, and a bigger one here. Collecting features, which can be similar to attack points, are features that you collect along the way to the control. A lot of the time, the contour lines of the map are extremely useful as collecting features, but at Shackleford Banks, that's not the case. There are so many depressions and dunes that you can't always be sure you're on the one you want to be on. Another common collecting feature you can use is other controls. Controls that are close to the control you need to get to and are easy to find are perfect for this, especially at Shackleford Banks. At Shackleford Banks, the vegetation boundaries make great handrails because most of the vegetation ends and begins abruptly and obviously, so it is easy to determine the relative area of where you are and easily follow it along like a trail. For this course, I would be starting near a bushy area, which means I had to make the decision to either bushwhack my way through or cut around and come at it from the east. I chose to bushwhack my way through, which in hindsight was not such a great idea. Not only does it take longer, especially when there's farther to go compared to my last Shackleford Banks bushwhacking experience, but it is easy to mess up your direction when you have to pay attention to the ground, to things your legs could get caught up in, and also things that might smack you on the face, leaving little brain power to pay attention to your map and compass. Eventually, I made it out, alive and only a little scratched, before finding my first control. I struggled to find my third control, which was 76. First, I ran around the bushy area here, but couldn't find it, so I headed towards a control that I had seen as I was running around. But when I found it, it wasn't a control on my map, so I wasn't able to use 64, the control I had found, as a catching feature, which is a feature you will hit if you've gone past the control so you know to stop before you run any farther. Eventually, though, I did find my third control because a fellow orienteer was nearby, and I moved on. For the rest of my course, that orienteer and I practically ran the course together because we were on the same one. My fourth control was much easier to find, as was the fifth one, which was super close to the coast, so it wasn't hidden by brush or surrounded by super tall dunes. For my sixth control, I used 76, my third control, as a collecting feature and was able to find it easily because other orienteers were also coming to the point at the same time I was. To get to the seventh control, I took advantage of the vegetation boundary to the north of the island to use as a trail for most of the way. Then I was able to spot another fence, which I used as a collecting feature on the way to that control. For 8, I was able to use this fence as an attack point, and for 9, I was able to follow the vegetation boundary as a handrail. For 10, I used that same trick until I reached the path, which I cut across before going about 100 meters to get to the control. The finish was easy to get to at an old bathhouse or porta potty building just off the coastline. Overall, this course was definitely not as much a success as my previous one had been, but that didn't mean I didn't have fun seeing the horses and breathing in the fresh, but cold, air.